Okay, so we'll get started, and I guess people will join us in the next 5 minutes as well. So welcome, good afternoon everyone, to this presentation on developing logic models for grant proposals. So my name is Armin Karamanian. I'm a research analyst in the research and evaluation team in the Office of the Superintendent at the Santa Clara County Office of Education. My colleague Brooke Reimer and I will be guiding you through this presentation today. I'd like to begin by explaining a little about our team and our work, as it may be helpful to you in future, should you be in need or be applying for a grant. The research and evaluation team are located at the Santa Clara County Office of Education's Ritter Park office. Our team works to support projects being administered by the Office of Education, or involving any of the 33 school districts in our county. Our team assists in the planning stages of the project by ensuring the outcomes of the project are clear and measurable, by communicating the evaluation methods we plan to use and how they will help tell a story of the success or shortcomings of a project. The success of our work is relied upon by our stakeholders to help secure continued funding or future funding and demonstrate the change made by the project to various stakeholders. In order to make our job possible and successful as researchers and to ensure the continuation of projects in support of students and educators, we rely on the development of a strong research proposal when applying for a grant. For this reason, we hope today's session will help strengthen your understanding of one element of a research proposal, the logic model. If throughout the presentation you have a question, please feel free to send a message through the chat feature, and Brooke and I will be having a look throughout the presentation and we'll aim to answer your questions at the end of the presentation. So today's presentation is on logic models, something that can appear complex and confusing. However, what I hope everyone will take from the presentation is just how important they are to the success of your project. As above all, the logic model will help you present the complex details of your project in a simple visual form to all your stakeholders and, most importantly, potential funders. Logic models will not only assist you in sourcing funds for you to complete your project, but will also help you better understand the different components of your project and its short-term and long-term effects. So, what is a logic model? Much like a roadmap, a logic model shows the route traveled or steps taken to reach a certain destination. It expresses the thinking behind a project's plan and explains why the project should work, why it can succeed, and where others attempted and failed. A logic model looks like visually. It can take on many different forms and can include flowcharts, maps, or tables. Your organization may already have a standard way in which a logic model is displayed. However, whichever form you choose, a logic model ought to provide direction and clarity by presenting the big picture of change along with certain important details. We'll now go over some examples of what different logic models look like. But don't worry about trying to remember them, as we will come back to the examples a little later in the presentation. So in this first example, we have a detailed logic model. This example is common and includes the inputs of the project, the outputs, and the outcomes. So we can see them shaded in yellow, blue, and green. These are three very basic components of a logic model, which we'll get into shortly. You will, however, notice arrows in the logic model. The arrows are, in fact, the most important part of the logic model, as they are the graphic representation of linkages between the inputs, activities, outputs, and outcomes. Without arrows, we just have boxes. With arrows, the things in one box produce the thing in the next, and so on. In this second example, once again, we see a detailed logic model displaying the inputs, the outputs, and the outcomes. However, this time, the logic model includes a short descriptive sentence of the situation. This is an important addition, as logic models can at times reveal information on the project's background to help the reader better understand the overall project. For example three, we have an example of something which is more visually appealing and has some interesting graphics. It still contains the three core components, but also includes other components such as reach and activities. The activities stem, you'll notice, grows out of the inputs. So the inputs is displayed as the ground soil, and the activities and outputs all grow out of these inputs. You will also notice that there are arrows, but not the same as in the other examples. The arrows linking the various components are colored black and red. This final example is my favorite, as it's visually appealing, but has great graphics and includes everything I would want to see in a logic model, including the assumptions, activities, and impact. This may not be what the submission wants to see. Take that in mind, only because most submissions have graphic and formatting limitations. So they may just want you to actually submit a table that looks like a very regular logic model. However, if you have the opportunity and you can be more creative, go for it. So now that we've seen some examples of what logic models look like, let's find out a bit more about the components of each logic model. The typical components of a logic model include the purpose or mission. Think about the problem the project is addressing. What is motivating the need for change? The context. What is the background of the project? Tell the reader what the project is about and what the external factors are. The inputs. So what are the raw materials? What raw materials will be used to complete the project? So in this situation with inputs, we're talking about funds. We're talking about participants, about agreements with school districts, with parents, et cetera. The activities, what the project will do with its resources to direct the course of change. Remember that activities are only possible with the inputs you listed. An activity may be, for example, a summer camp program or an after-school care center. However, these are only possible with funding and participation from teachers and other staff. The outputs. What evidence is there that the activities were performed as planned? As part of a project, you might use student participation in a particular activity as an output. And the effects. What kinds of changes came about as a direct or indirect effect of these activities? Think about the short-term, mid-term, and longer-term effects of the project. So now that we've covered the components of a logic model, let's go back to the examples that we saw earlier and see where each of these components are found. So in the first example, we can see several of the components described. The inputs are listed on the left. These include the resources that are going into the project. Then we have the outputs in the middle, which are inclusive of the activities that are being performed as a result of the resources put into the project. And the outcomes on the right-hand side. And the outcomes are split into short-term, mid-term, and long-term effects, usually within a year, within 2 years, or within 5 to 10 years. So in the second example, which was my final example previously, we can see all the components. There's assumptions, there's inputs, activities, outputs, outcomes, and so on. Whilst working with the core components of the logic model is essential, including other components, such as the assumptions of the project, the organization's vision and purpose, will help you get the message across to your stakeholders and funders, especially if this is the sole document you might be presenting to a group of people. The more they understand about the project, the better. However, there is no better logic model than the original for all the Trekkie fans we have out there. If you're not a Trekkie fan, then don't worry about this slide. So, when can a logic model be used? other than including a logic model in a grant proposal, where else can you make use of the logic model? Logic models are useful in new and existing projects. If your project is still being planned, a logic model can help get it off to a good start. Alternatively, if your project is already underway, a model can help you describe it and modify it. Some examples of when a logic model can be used include during planning. A logic model can help clarify the program strategy, identify appropriate outcomes, and most importantly, avoid overpromising. It can align your efforts with those of other organizations, and when writing a grant proposal, estimating timelines, identifying partnerships, and negotiating roles and responsibilities. They can also be used during implementation. Logic models can come in handy during implementation to provide an inventory of what you have and what you need to operate the program or initiative. Incorporate findings from the research, make mid-course adjustments, reduce or avoid unintended effects. It helps remind you and others of the resources and inputs of the project that you have. They're used quite commonly during staff and stakeholder meetings. They help to explain how the overall project works, show how different people can work together, define what each person is expected to do, and indicate how we can know if the program is actually working. Staff are continuously able to refer back to the model at any time to clarify their own duties. And finally, during evaluation, it comes in handy to document your accomplishments, identify differences between the ideal program and its real operation, prepare your reports, and finally, tell the story of the program itself, and most importantly, to help secure continued funding for your project. Your logic model is going to help you during numerous stages of your program or your project, but why is it so important in your grant proposal? To begin with, it is worth noting that not all grant proposals require logic models, but when they do, it is to let the funder know a very important message about your project, how it can work. After all, they are providing money and funds, so they want to know how these funds are going to contribute to the long-term results of your project. When you include complex elements in your grant proposal, like logic models, it lets the funder know you have a well-thought-out plan for a project, and it visually expresses why the program will succeed. It basically lends to your credibility. Logic models are appreciated by the reader because it's a snapshot of your intentions and may answer questions that were not addressed in the grant proposal itself. After all, a picture is worth a thousand words. The more specific information you include about your project, the better. Funders want specific details on the process your project will take to get results. Logic models are a great tool to include in your grant proposal's evaluation section, as it's able to summarize the specific and complex information into an easily digestible message. So I'm now going to switch over to my colleague, Brooke, who will be covering an example of a logic model for a project, followed by a group activity. So over to you, Brooke.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm Brooke Reimer. I'm a research analyst with the research and evaluation team. I will be walking you through an example logic model, and then we'll work on filling out another logic model together. So in this example, we need to develop a logic model for an after-school program. This program will operate in each school district in Santa Clara County and will look after elementary school children for 2 hours following the end of the school day. So the overall goal of the program is to reduce the number of kids at home alone after school. Getting to this goal will involve the help of administrators. These personnel will conduct attendance workshops with coordinators and staff at program centers to educate the audience about the program benefits for the children. There are 6 components we need to consider to reach this goal. First is inputs. This is everything that goes into the project. We have funding that helps run the program, We have allocated staff hours. We have after-school program curriculum, which outlines how the centers will be run. And then there's the available centers in each school district that we can utilize, and guidelines for coordinators who will supervise the kids. When we have those inputs, we can then conduct the activities, which is what the project will do with the resources to conduct change. For this, we will need to speak with the people running the program, the coordinators, which makes the first activity, conduct workshops on attendance and the value of after-school programs. After we conduct the activities using our inputs, we would then ideally have inputs. We need to understand what evidence there is that the activities were performed as planned. For this, we need to look at the outcomes of the workshops that are being run. In the activity column, we have the action. In the outputs column, we have the outputs or the results of the activity or activities. We then need to consider the three outcomes or effects. Note that you don't always have to have a short-term, a midterm, and a long-term outcome. You can decide which of these you need based on the project. For this project, short-term outcomes would be increased attendance by students at the after-school program, fewer students at home alone. Midterm outcome could be the value added to the mental health and well-being of students attending the after-school programs. A long-term outcome would be heightened sense of well-being and motivation as a result of attending the after-school programs and not being home alone, as well as possibly happier children. The longer the term of the outcome, the broader the outcome of the program. Okay, so as a group activity and a way to help us all become familiar with building a logic model, I'd like us to fill out a logic model template together. I'll drop the link in the chat and you can't click it right now. First, the purpose is to get you to think about what areas of the project or what elements you would include in each column. Shortly, I'll ask everyone to click on the link to the Google document and input their thoughts. It can be anonymous. I'll go through your responses afterward, kind of an aggregate, summarizing what's written. There is no right or wrong answer. We're all just practicing. So our problem statement is on the screen, and it states, low-income high school students in selected communities in Santa Clara County attend college at a lower rate than their middle-class peers, leading to more limited opportunities, higher rates of unemployment, and lower earnings. So think about the problem statement and how the issue can be addressed. One tip I would give would be to think about building programs, creating initiatives, including various types of stakeholders. So if you can please access the link that I just put in the chat and begin filling out any and all areas of the logic model that you can. We will have about 10 minutes to fill this out. If you have questions, feel free to send them in the chat and I will address them as they pop up.
There's so many good suggestions made here. And Tina, thank you for your message as well. So as a reminder to everyone that don't worry about trying to copy down the information. This whole thing will be emailed to you following the presentation. So
so if you'd like to send us questions or queries relating to this course, please do so at the following email addresses. We would really like to thank you all. And we like to request that you take a minute to complete the post-training survey using the tiny URL link. This, I can send it in the chat as well. You'll also receive the link after you complete the course. So thank you all for taking part in the workshop on developing logic models for grant proposals. We hope you enjoy the rest of your day.
Thanks, everyone.